owners make you stop.
Man, you can make a lot of stuff, man.
You want the hooker to get stopped. Sometimes you want to get off, man. And two. Oh, give me my other hand.
Man. And if you stop, I'm not a beaver.
Wat maak je met die geweren? Moenie!
That stuff I filmed yesterday attracted the wrong attention.
Yeah, I know, and it's bad news, man. If any of those guys get arrested as a result of your film, you can forget about working in the townships again.
Hey, I just filmed it. I didn't make it happen.
You can't just film any way you like. Those people trusted you. That's why they allowed you in there in the first place.
Tozanele, somebody was killed. Now, what am I supposed to do? Just stand there and watch? It's my job to get the story.
Then tell the whole story. What do those millions of viewers across the world see? Yet another example of black-on-black violence. Now, is that the story you want to tell?
No, but it happens.
Of course it happens, but then it happens for a reason. And it's your duty to point that out.
Look, I record what I see as objectively as possible.
That's easy for you to say. You're not the one who's having his head kicked in. But then you're only there because you're paid.
Oh, don't give me that crap. For the last 4 years, I've been shot at, tear gassed, stoned, arrested, beaten up.
Welcome to South Africa. Except I can't go home to the safety of my white skin at the end of the day.
Jesus, Tozamili. What is this? I care about this country just as much as you do.
Then wake up, man. Stop hiding behind your camera. Get involved. You have the power to tell the real story about this country. Not just sensational bullshit. Otherwise, you are no different from your poor brothers who are causing the shit in the first place.
coming.
Hey, we've got it already.
Watch it.
You people, let's get out now very quickly, okay? Because you people are the fucking cause of this now.
Yeah, all right.
So get out.
Okay. No, you're not the cause of
it. Don't come and talk shit to me now.
The police were in here this afternoon. They want to know what the hell happened out there.
What did you tell them?
Oh, I bought us some time. You have to leave town while I do some fancy footwork and placate some ruffled feathers and save both our asses. God knows I've done it before. I'm sending you to Namibia for a couple of days. Charles Rutherford is looking for a cameraman.
What? You must be joking. I know Soak hasn't seen any real action since the war in Zimbabwe.
Listen, he may not be your style, but he survived 20 years in this business.
18 months ago, Nadeep killed his first victim in this dusty sheep farming area of Southwest Africa. Today, he struck again, killing two farm laborers.
He only seems to go for his own tribespeople.
He's left a trail of devastation with five dead and scores maimed and wounded. The local police have mounted an extensive hunt for Nadeep over the past 2 years, but without success.
See if we can get Charles a scratch beneath the surface just for a change.
Or how he selects his targets. But this elusive renegade has become so good at avoiding capture that he's become something of a legend amongst his own people, the Nama. Charles Rutherford, Viscom News, Namibia.
Oh, terrible, man, terrible.
Yes, Charlie? It's a bit hot today, huh?
What are you doing here? Local air traffic controller as well now?
No, just checking up on you. You know you can never trust an Englishman.
So I hear that new boyke of yours is filming riots and stuff in Soweto, eh?
Must be interesting. Like to hear some of his stories.
Bit of a sensitive subject right now. I wouldn't mention it if I were you. This is meant to be a break for him.
Yeah, Prince Charlie. It's good to sweat. Maybe it'll make a man out of you.
Thank you.
Anton, welcome. Long time no see.
Hello, Helmut Soderberg.
Right, hello.
Sergeant of Lucie, but call me Platfoot. Welcome to Southwest.
Anton van Heerden.
An Afrikaner. I was beginning to believe all newsmen were a bunch of foreigners. I hear you were checking out Kaffirs knocking each other up in Soweto. Charlie has said I should ask you.
This, believe it or not, is the local expert on that heap. Little wonder that I haven't been able to catch him.
Don't you believe a word he says, Anton.
This is Joey, who's our guide, interpreter. Well, he's not drunk as a skunk.
Hi, Joey.
He'll do anything you ask, except work. You want lekker frotty on the Engels, huh? So if you're warm club, to gaan lie up. Wacht, I must get going. Listen, if you have any trouble with this Engelsman, just call me. Bye, guys.
Anton, you see all these farms here? Many of them are empty now. Because of nothing. You just can't find namas to work on these farms anymore. They're too scared of Nadine. Well, you know, without boys, nothing is possible.
What interests me is that the Nama believe that he's magical. He's indestructible. Believe that he can change himself into a rock or the wind. Anything he likes.
Yeah. But to them, anyone who can run away from the white man for so long must be a magician. Tell me, have you been to Southwest before?
Namibia.
Namibia, well, call it what you like. The Bushmen call it the land God created in a temper.
What the Bushmen meant was the arsehole of the universe.
Is that why you're passing through it, eh, Charles? Charles, you're just jealous because you haven't got a desert in England, eh?
Here we are, in that deep country.
Hang on.
Aaron!
Mama's coming.
Daar die kat. Kom nou.
Ach, ma.
And where do you think you're going?
Missus?
Round the back, man. They pretend they're so stupid. Believe me, they know bloody well.
Nothing fancy.
This is fine.
If you need anything else, you just speak to my wife. She runs the place. I only look after the bar. Okay.
Thank you.
Father, ne deji, eskay de aku, ne yete ha, eskay de gile ha, an da dang.
Kaisi ayo.
Ne nanu ke sores na kasi ko ngari cham, sige tang ma.
Morning, Joey.
Hello, boss.
Tell me, Joey, do you know Nadeep?
I never met him, boss.
Joey, do me a favor.
Please don't call me boss. Do you believe he has magic?
Sorry, boss?
Do you believe he can fly with the wind, turn into things, stuff like that?
They tell me so, boss.
You think they're going to catch him?
We're going to catch him. Don't worry. He's like a rabbit. He runs here, he runs there. Nobody can catch him. You can't catch the wind. Never. Never.
It's not that I believe all those stories that the Nama say about Nadeep, that he can turn himself into a stone or a bird or whatever. But take the night he shot Klaas. That's the Nama that worked for us for 22 years. My husband was in town with the police. Somebody had heard that they'd seen Nadeep in town. And that same night, Nadeep shot Klaas right here on the farm, while my husband was in town looking for him. So now how do you explain that? My husband says, you mustn't put this on TV. My husband says, the Namas are so lazy that if they don't want to work, they'll see Nadeep everywhere.
Please, go on.
But it's getting very hard for us. You know, I suppose it's because even though you know it's a lot of nonsense, you start believing those stories yourself about Nadeep. The whole time you get this feeling that he's watching you. I get worried about my husband going into the mountains. I always think Nadeep is going to shoot him. Not that he's ever shot a white. I just wish they'd hurry up and find him because it gets on my nerves. I mean, otherwise I don't know what's going to happen to us.
You want to know about this bloody Nadeep, I'll tell you, he's nothing but a rapist, man, a sex maniac. You know, I reckon he'll kill anybody just for the bloody hell of it.
We used to always say, just let the terrorists come down here to the south and we would sort them out, eh? But now, here's this madman going around killing people. And we can't do a thing, hey, Sarge? One hot knot with a gun and he's got to get the army to fix it.
Now, he's got to make a mistake. They will get him. I can tell you that much.
Man, that's a belief. When?
Hey! You'll get him. Don't you worry.
Down, 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 three.
No.
We shall have to come out of the road.
Wil jij verdomde Bobby aan, man? Zie ik maar iets in die koppen gezien.
Genade van ons Here Jesus Christus, die liefde.
Morning.
Die genade van ons Here Jesus Christus, die liefde van God en die gemeenskap van die Heilige Gees. Bly met elkeen van u.
Yeah.
hello there.
Welcome, welcome. Glad you could make it.
Oh, happy birthday, man.
Pardon, Stella.
Do come in. Come and join the party.
How's your head this morning, then?
Charles, let me introduce you to our local Member of Parliament, Maynard.
You're making a film about Nadeep?
If the man exists, I'm beginning to have my doubts.
And this is his cameraman, Anton van Heerden.
Pleased to meet you.
Thank you. Welcome.
Sorry, this is Henna.
Johnny.
Don't worry about him. This business of Nadeep is a very touchy subject around here.
He's just been bloody difficult.
That may be so, but I reckon he's got a lot of sense, you know, while the rest of the farmers are selling up. He's busy buying. Anyway, a drink.
Yeah. Beer, please.
Come on.
You see, you have these people of the media going around saying Nadeep is a victim of apartheid and all that nonsense. It just isn't the case. You see this?
It's over there, okay?
Yeah. Let me in if you fall, Leo. Now my flesh is too bitter to eat. You know, you guys must come and film on my farm. Nadeep shot one of my shepherds there last year, and I can't get boys to work there anymore. You know, I stopped counting, but I...
Praat Afrikaans, meneer man.
Verstaan jy nou Afrikaans? En toch is jy Engelsman.
Strand. Van Heerden, pure Afrikaner.
I'm afraid my Afrikaans is very bad.
Look. That kaffir's cost us more than the whole drought. Now, you want to make a bloody film about it?
Well, the film is actually about the manhunt.
Why don't you rather make a film about your own people? Us, the farmers. Or aren't you interested in your own people anymore?
Henning, kom. Henning, kom nou, man.
Those whites that wanted to go, they're gone long ago. And those that wanted to stay like me, we're accepting the situation as it is right now. I mean, we can't just pick up and leave and run to South Africa. There we don't know who's who, who we face.
Excuse toch. Nadeep's been shooting at Henning's farm. Let's go.
Gone with the wind again. What is the name of the town? Shit. Kom, altijd gaat weg. Ergens moet hij langs. Gerrit.
Wat?
It's amazing nobody was killed in here. Peterson, the Mubin Herald, how's it?
Tom van Heeren, this come news.
Hi.
It's all because of the baby that this happened, you know?
What?
That woman out there with the kid?
Who do you think is the father?
Go and ask the big white boss what happened here.
Ons was binnen.
Kom, my magtig, ek dan vir eerlik sê, jy moet oppas, man. Waar was jy toe?
Ek was binnenkin, was ek het maar te binnenkin in gehadloe, was toes het binnenkin was.
Ja?
Toes kie dat hier die deur ook...
Luister, ek praat, wat?
Toes kie dat hier die deur ook was. Kijk, die skoot waar op die deur was. Ons was bang geweest, was.
Ja, maar...
Want die was baie kwaad, was. Ons was baie...
What the hell do you think you're doing? Come on, get off! This is private property, no one's here to film you. Come on, get off.
get off my phone, you vultures. Hey, come on, you've got no business here.
Take it easy. No.
Get off! Come on, Anton.
For Christ's sake.
Get in.
Nothing better than a lack of horse cock. Once he gets into the mountains, you can forget about it.
You think he's still around?
Don't worry about Nadeep. Doesn't kill whites. He's just killing his own people. He could have killed me a long time ago if he wanted to. Many times. Helicopters and fancy night vision and what have you. Doesn't help you, nothing. If you really want to catch this guy, you'll have to do it with a bit of luck. He's laughing at them.
You must know him quite well by now.
Well, man, I thought more about him over the last 18 months than I thought about my own wife. You know, you feel so small when you come back after weeks in the mountain. People point at you and they say, you're too stupid to catch him, mate. You know, often I'd find his tracks. And he'd been watching me the whole time. He's clever little Arnold. Did you know he can write? He only was in school for 2 years. But he writes poems and that.
just inside follows surprise, and then suspicion. Reach, stand still. Reassure me, please. Just beginning, still beginning.
Probably not the right time to tell you, old cop, but the water here is not unrelated to the stuff that we flushed down the lavatory. If I were you, I'd stick to the beer.
So, what do you think?
This half beast, half man, will-o'-the-wisp legend of the South, seems he also writes. I'd hardly call him Byron.
Give him a break. He only spent 2 years at school.
Well, then Byron run with the wind and fly with the clouds.
Do you think he's politically motivated?
God, no. No leader of men. Far too individual for that. There's integrity in what he does. The sense of Adam imbued with primitive, original rage. Oh, I think I'd enjoy hanging out with him in the 60s. When freedom is outlawed, only the outlaws will be free. Nadeep is a classic outlaw. Frankly, I think the Namas just love his ability to avoid capture. Famished. You coming?
Yeah, I'll be along.
Compton, sit up. There you go.
Okay. So how are we feeling?
Conservas.
Shame he has a headache. But he's tough. He'll get better quickly. Nee, opa. Hulle wil weet wat gebeur het met Nadeep.
Nadeep?
Ja, alles wat gebeur het. Hoe hy gemaak het. Hoekom hy geskiet het.
Die story van Nadeep is niks te wijzen met my son. Voor wat wil hy voor my skiet?
He says he didn't do anything to upset Nadeep. He doesn't know why he shot him. Nee, tomorrow, Opa. He's still a bit confused. Maybe you should speak to Yankee. Shh, okay. Or Obut. Obut, die TV wil met jou praat. Doen het weer.
Are they both victims of Nadeep?
Yes. And there's some more in the ladies' room.
Charles, let's just get a shot of him. Forget the interview.
Oh, fine, okay.
That's fine. Don't worry about this.
I had seen. Tila had come on. It's the high fruit. It's not if you fruit.
What?
I had seen the mother had come on. It's the high fruit. It's not if you fruit.
Charles, you said something about the woman on the farm being Nadeep's woman? Hannes, is that his child?
Oh, come on, for Christ's sake, get the shot before he falls to pieces completely.
Perhaps we can get to Nadeep through her.
Be sensible. He's not going to waste his time with women and children. Oh, we screwed that one. So who's next?
This is what the government set aside as a farming reserve for the Nama. Can you believe it?
Could you possibly farm here? His new meaning is getting blood out of a stone.
Now the Nam used to rule the whole of southern Namibia, man. Now they got this.
Unbelievable. Which one's Nadeep's father? You okay?
Yeah. Really?
In a country with such a diversity of people and culture,
And after nearly a century of colonial rule, Nadeep has become every man's legend. A murderer, a liberator, mystic, a hero. And though his real motives remain a mystery, to many he has come to personify the lost freedom of the Nama, whose territory this was before the imposition of German rule and the historical successor, South Africa. Cut.
All right then, here we are.
Great.
You got it?
Thanks,
sir. Cheers.
Cheers. Soon died.
Yes, cheers to Nadeep. Long may he live, though I doubt it.
Why?
Because he's got no guilt. Whereas a common criminal may well surrender, go quietly. Not Nadeep.
Goed, man, jullie is allemaal Nadeep voor. Ons. Because maybe he's just a madman with a gun, going around killing people for the hell of it. And here we are, turning him into some kind of legend.
Well, who cares? So long as his acts of violence threaten the very basis of society, there's still hope for change.
Ma!
What?
You may not come in here. There's a bark or colored in the back.
Oh, for God's sake.
Hello.
Ma!
Time to leave, chaps.
He can't drink in here.
He's a friend of mine.
I don't care if it is the state president's friend. They've got their own bar. Come.
Can you give me a ride?
Of course. Sorry about that.
Don't let it bother you. I should have realized.
Come and look here, Charles. Look. And I'm telling you now in plain English. No Kaffirs and knock-knocks in here. Nooit. What, Miss Abbott? And I don't care what people say.
Extraordinary. English language will never be the same. Where are you going?
Back to my fellow lepers.
Are you coming?
No, I stay here, keep the peace.
Fuck her.
I'd rather not, thank you.
What are you doing?
Sorry.
It's my turn to get kicked out.
Wow, you should be so lucky. Nah, they just came for that a white man should bother to come in here in the first place. What you can have?
Oh, this is on me. I owe you one.
And hey, two cold ones, bro.
Why are there no Namas in here?
Well, nothing's stopping them, but apartheid is a contagious disease. Monkey see, monkey do. See, us colored people, we're far too in with the whites to mix with Namas. Cheers.
Cheers.
Listen. You guys better be careful about over-romanticizing Nadeep. Don't forget one thing, he kills Namas, not whites. Some people around here, I guess they like that.
What do you mean?
Do you really think Nadeep could get this far without protection from the whites? How do you think he manages to disappear every time they're hunting for him, without a trace? Where does he get his guns from, his bullets?
He steals them, obvious.
And what about the girlfriend on the farm, hmm? And do you know that Nadeep sends his grandfather money at the end of every month? What about that?
What are you saying?
I'm saying that maybe somebody is paying Nadeep a salary.
What? To kill Namas?
Listen, bushman hunting used to be a sport around here not so long ago. The only difference is now they've hired a black man to do it for them.
Oh, who's gonna pay him?
You guys, man, you're walking around here in a daydream. Look, All I'm going to say is that there are some people, white people, who are buying up these farms very cheap now, thanks to Nadeep.
That makes Nadeep into a mercenary.
With both hands in the cookie jar. But please, don't let these little details spoil your movie, huh? Yeah, I used to believe in Nadeep's power and his magic. Once. Excuse me.
You're doing there. You're the colored man. Oh!
Whoops.
It wasn't funny, stupid.
Thought you were ready.
Come on, old cop, cheer up. Nobody really knows anything about Nadeep, not even his own family. Everybody seems to be making up willy-nilly as they go along.
Including you?
Including me.
Well, maybe it is true. Maybe Nadeep is just a mercenary. Why not? God knows it won't be the first time this sick society has created a monster like that.
Come on. Show me a country that hasn't had its own share of violence. And believe me, I've seen most of them.
All this because some bastard wants to buy farms cheaply. Henning.
Oh, forget it.
Of course, Charles. Who else is buying up farms around here? And why was he so keen to get us away from his farm? Because he allows Nadeep to hide there, that's why. And that explains the woman. We put two and two together.
Well, hang on, you don't even know for sure that she's Nadeep's girl.
Well, maybe Nadeep's been blackmailed. The baby. Henning's using the baby to get Nadeep to do those things.
Anton. The baby's only about 6 months old. Nadeep's been killing for nearly 2 years.
Well, everyone else is making up their version of him.
Can I help?
Hello. We're the film crew. I called you a few days ago.
Ah, yes. Hello. Come to film our little ceremony.
Well, yes. And to see if you've changed your mind about giving an interview on Nadeep. We've read some of his writings and we find it very hard to believe that he was at school for such a short time.
Yes, well, we must remember that he was 12 when he started. But he was a bright boy, definitely.
What was he like?
Very quiet, though he had a terrible temper. He used to bite the other boy sometimes. But can I offer you a drink?
Oh, that'd be lovely.
Oh, yeah. Sit, please, sit.
Thank you.
I'm sure our gallant warriors won't miss a few.
Why does he attack only his own people?
You know much about the Nama people, Mr.
Van Heerden, Anton. No, not much.
The Namas are a proud people, Mr. Van Heerden. I suspect Nadeep finds it very hard to accept what's happened to his people over the years. Their humiliation, subservience. So he hits out at his own people. I suppose it's like hitting somebody you love when it's yourself you feel angry with.
I was told he was being paid to kill Namas.
You hear so many stories these days, Mr. Van Heerden, that you hardly know which one to believe.
What about the woman and baby on Henning's farm? We were there after the last shooting.
Marta? You know about her? Yeah. This business about the baby must have broken his heart into 1,000 pieces. Poor man.
What business?
Look, as I've said, you don't know what to believe any longer. But you must excuse me now, please. If our warriors don't get their drink soon, I'll have a real war on my hands.
The interview?
No, please. Later, perhaps. But good luck with your phone. Maybe it will really put this place on the map for a change.
Yes, maybe.
Remember our great leaders who tried to unite the people of Namibia against the foreign occupation of our land. Remember also those who died for our country. We greet them with the following words. We salute you and all our forefathers who bravely resisted colonial rule and died for the liberation of our country. We know that the struggle will be long and that some will fall by the wayside. But we, the younger generation, promise today, after 100 years, that we will continue with the struggle until the bells of independent Namibia are rung one day.
Say, the more the day wears on, the more difficult it becomes to tell the difference between the Germans and the Namas.
Yeah, and the more history gets rewritten.
Why not? History is what you measure, my friend. I see that Charles has found some soulmates. Real colonial relics, that bunch, man.
I don't like this. Henning might leave the pageant early.
Don't worry. We're white. We're protected.
What? Last time he nearly shot us.
Look, I just want to ask somebody if that's Nadeep's baby.
He's not here. Thank you very much. Get in.
We're onto something here, Charles.
Can't just barge into people's houses.
Okay, relax. No harm done.
He could have arrived while you were in there, for Christ's sake.
Then I would have asked him what the hell's going on. Charles, if Marta is Nadeep's lover and that's his child, we can prove Henning's using him.
Why did he try and kill her?
I don't know. Let's go and find out.
Nobody is going to hire a hitman so they can buy a couple of farms cheaply. It's suicide.
You've made no effort to get Nadeep's side of the story. Nothing. Now, if you want to understand this country, you better get to the heart of the story. I can't afford to hide behind ethics and search warrants. What I report is more than news, Charles. It's my life, it's my future.
How you deal with your guilt is your business. But at this minute, you're working for me, and I expect at least some pretense at objectivity.
Your problem is that you avoid the truth. It upsets your comfortable little movies.
The truth? What do you mean by the truth? Your determination to hold Henning responsible for Nadeep not turning out the way that you want him to seems a very curious perception of the truth to me, if you don't mind me saying so.
I don't know, Charles. I live here, you don't.
Nothing. Nothing matters. My body, nothing. Departed to death. And you once saw an excellent wife. But there was something wrong with you, spiritually. Now I shall see that things turn out as I want them. Now I shall see that things turn out as I want them.
What about?
Could I speak to your daughter, please?
Bas, me basal bhaye kwa dur bas.
Look, I understand, but I won't be long. Thank you.
Martha?
Oh, puppy?
Please, don't be frightened. I just want to talk to you about Nadeep and the baby.
Get away from that baby.
What are you doing here, Fanny?
I told you. We're doing a film on Nadeep.
Yeah? So what do you want from my people? What have these Kaffirs been telling you?
I got nothing to tell you, boss.
That's the very pass for you.
They haven't told me anything. What are you doing? Are you crazy?
Yeah, Fanny, and I'm crazy. I suppose they told you that I paid Nadeep to kill all those Kaffirs.
You're gonna kill him!
Like lies! All bloody lies! He was killing long before I bought those farms.
Look, I came here because I thought she might be Nadeep's woman. No other reason.
He wishes. He's too busy believing that story that he's a hero or something. But here on my farm, he's only another whatnot. Rahmata.
So you are hiding him here?
I wasn't hiding him. I mean, nobody tells Nadeep what to do.
But you allow him to stay here, to make sure he's not caught.
Maybe I didn't see him. I mean, how must I know what my Kaffirs are getting up to?
And meanwhile, you're just buying up farms.
You newspeople, you know fuck all. I mean, why didn't you fuck off back to Soweto? That's where you belong. You're not one of us anymore. You bastard!
Thank you.
you going, you bloody... Lightfoot, your moor!
Yeah, Nadeep. Just you and me, till the end, eh?
Sees man.
Right. Let's see. Let's see if you got the right man here.
There, man.
Joey, what do they say? Come on, man, wake up.
She saying, where is his face?
What?
Nadeep has been shot in the face, Charles.
Sir?
She's saying that if it's Nadeep, then where is his
face? See, some people don't believe it's Nadeep. They think someone else has been shot to try and trick them into going back onto the farms.
Oh, give me a break. Sergeant?
People have asked what prayers can be spoken at the grave of such a man. Friends, Nadib is today being buried as a black man. No, because he killed or he stole or hurt, but in recognition of the resistance he gave to the colonizers of our land, for reminding us of our strength, our spirit, our glorious past. Let us sing.
Charles.
What the hell for?
To find Martha and the baby. Why aren't they here? And Gerrit?
What do you mean?
I think they're in danger.
Maybe Nadeep stole that pistol. But maybe Henning gave it to him. The only people who know are those two.
Don't leave that to the police.
I can't. Not now. Not after this. If it wasn't for me, Nadeep might still be alive.
No. That was inevitable. Please, drop it.
That's exactly what Henning expects me to do. That's why people like him have power in this country.
Expect me to come with you?
I don't.
God, you angst-ridden boors can be a pain in the ass.
I'm not a boor. I'm an Afrikaner.
If you have to go, go. But for God's sake, watch your back. I don't want to attend another funeral. Go on, then.
Mensen hier in de hardloop. Hij baart het mensen die komen gaan slaan. Ja, daar in de hardloop, willen ze daar in de bergen in. Ik weet niet waar naar doen.
What's it, mommy?
You're in shit from here, then. What do you want here? What marking?
Where is Martha?
Don't worry about my people. I do with them what I like. Same as I did with Nadeep.
You used him. What? You fucking used him.
Jesus. You know nothing about him. I brought him out of the mountains. I showed that he's no good. The Nama think he's powerful, but I proved he's a real person. None of this magic business. But then he mustn't fuck with me. I tamed him and I fucking broke him.
Stay where you are.
You can shoot me? Why don't you fight me? Like a true Afrikaner. Come on! From me. What did I do to you? You don't understand. He came to me because, oh fuck it, I tried to stop this thing. I understood him. They think he's something great. But he's nothing. I let him stay to show he's just a whatnot. Problem is now he can be anything. Even magic. Why do we fight? We Afrikaners must stick together.
Thank you.